In this video, I'm going to show you exactly how you can set up your own Pterodactyl server so you can run game servers such as Satisfactory, Rust, Minecraft, CSGO, etc. Let's get straight into it. Okay, so to get started, we're going to need a VPS or a server. So for this, we're going to be using Volta. So all you need to do is just create an account here, and then once you've logged in, you're going to be brought to a products page, and this will show what servers you currently have active. So all we need to do from here is go to the right hand side and then click on the little plus symbol here and then click deploy new server. So here we're going to get to choose the server itself. You've got the high frequency, the cloud compute, bare metal, or dedicated cloud. For most people, for game servers, if it's just you and a few friends, you can just do the cloud compute. If you need something with like a better CPU, then you can go with a high frequency, and if still that's not enough, you can go with a bare metal or a dedicated cloud. Just one thing, you can actually upgrade. So if you start on a smaller plan, you can upgrade to a better system later on, and Volta will automatically just upgrade whatever system you're on. So for now, we're just going to start with the cloud compute. Then the server location, ideally you want to select whatever country or city is nearest to you. So I'm just going to click on Singapore. Now we need server type. So for this, we're going to be selecting Ubuntu 20.04. That's what we'll be using for Pterodactyl. Now we get to the server size. So this is where you select how much RAM your server has, how many CPU cores. For this, we're going to be using the 160GB SSD version, 4 CPU cores, 8GB of RAM. And then if we scroll down, this is just, we need to type in a host name. So we go, we just call it Petro for now. Then we just click on deploy. Then you just need to wait probably 5 to 10 minutes for this to deploy on the server, and then we'll come back to it. Okay, so now that we've got our instance set up, we just need to click on Petro. So it's going to take us into the control panel of our little VPS server itself. You're going to see a few things here. You're going to see the IP address, you're going to see the username, and you're going to see the password. So we're just going to click on copy password. And then we can actually view the server console. So we can click on this little button on the top right here. It's going to take us directly to the server console. So if you come to the screen and it doesn't say, for example, Petro login, just press enter and it should load up straight away. So we're going to type in our username, so which was root. And then we already copied our password. So we're going to click on send clipboard, and it says pasting. Now it's not actually going to show anything because it's just something with Linux, it just doesn't show whatever password you've typed in. So we can just press enter, and as you can see, it's just logged us into the server now. So from here, if you look in the description, there's going to be a little script in there from Wilhelm Pritz. I'm not sure that's how you pronounce it, but sorry mate. I'm just going to grab that now, and then we're going to put it straight into this window here. Okay, so now I've copied it, you can just click on send clipboard again and then press enter. So there's actually two parts to Pterodactyl, there's a panel and wings, and we want to install both. So this option we're going to select is 2. And then it's just going to ask us for a few things here. So we've got the database name. If we just press enter, it's just going to give the default details. If it's just a server for you and friends, it's fine just to leave it as default, otherwise change it up however you want if there's going to be lots of other people joining. So we can just leave a generated password, then let's the time zone, I'm going to change that since Asia, Singapore, and then the email address. So put in your email address here, you put it in again. And then the initial username, so I'm just going to use Podrotsky. First and last name. The super strong password. Now it's going to come here, it's going to say set the FQDN, so it's like fully qualified domain name. Now what we're going to do, we're just going to use the IP address of the server itself, so we can grab the IP address here. And then click send to clipboard, And then it's going to say, do you want to automatically configure the firewall? We want to configure it. Now, here's where it says, do you want to automatically configure HTTPS? Now, you'd only do that if you're using a domain name. Now, because we're not, we're just using IP, we'll select no. And then it's just going to come up with a little warning here. So let's select no. And then we'll just continue the installation. So we're going to let that go through. And that should probably take about 5 to 10 minutes, and then we'll come back to it. Okay, so now it's just asks us in the install, do we want to automatically configure a user for database hosts? Let's just click yes. And then again, we can just put this in, just Pterodactyl user, and then we can put in whatever password we want for the database. To be honest, it's probably something you're not really going to use anyway, so just write the password and username down, which will be, if you just press enter, Pterodactyl user, and then enable the firewall again. And then again, it's going to ask configure HTTPS, to select no and proceed with the installation. All right, so now we're at the end of the install. Now it's going to say a few things here. So it's like Wings installation completed. It's like you can start Wings manually or verify that it's working. So you can see here it's got sudo wings. So we'll just type that in now. There's no configuration on there, but we just want to see if it actually loads. So sudo wings. And it says their configuration file not found, so that should be fine. Now this is where we've got to log into our Pterodactyl panel, and then we'll add our server and the Wings configuration. So let's do that now. So to do this, we need to come back to our panel. We need to grab our IP address, and then we can actually just put it straight up in the taskbar here. So we can go straight to the IP, and it should bring up the Pterodactyl login. And you can just use the login that you created just a minute ago. And now you're at the Pterodactyl panel. So now we've got to add the wings to the panel, basically. So if we just click on settings in the top right hand corner, we go down to locations first. We have to set a location first. So I'm just going to create one. I'm just going to call it SG for Singapore. Call it whatever you want, really. That's just a like distinguisher for you. And then we click on nodes, click on create new, and then we're just gonna create a name for it. So call it Singapore. Now FQDN, this is just where your IP address is gonna go. So put the IP address in there. And then we're going to click use HTTP connection. So if we were using a domain name, then we would use SSL. Now this is also where you put in the total memory you have. So it's 8096, it's 8 gigabytes of RAM. The memory over allocation, we'll just set that to 0, disk over allocation. Total hard drive space, I think it was 180 gigabytes. So that's 180 gig. Then you just leave everything else the same. So the only things you really need to change is the memory and the total disk space, just to match whatever system you have. You can obviously change this and just leave a bit more overhead for the system itself, but I've always found just doing it this way is fine. And then, yeah. So let's click on create node. Okay, and then this is allocation. This is where you assign ports, but we're not going to do this just yet. We're actually going to go to configuration. And then we're going to click on the right hand side here. It says generate token. Then we need to copy this line in here. So we'll copy that. Then we need to go back to our server. So then we're going to click send clipboard. We'll just wait for that to print out. So that's imported the configuration. So now if we go sudo wings, as you can see, wings has loaded up. So then we just press control C. And then once we've verified that wings actually works, we're gonna type in systemctl start wings and then press enter. And then if we wanna check if that's running, we can go systemctl status wings. As you see there, it says running, so we can just press Control C to back out of that again. And then we just go back to Pterodactyl, just click OK here. And then if we click on nodes, we should see there's a little green heart on our Singapore server. So that means we can actually deploy games to our Pterodactyl panel. So after this, it's pretty simple. So if we click on the node again, actually, we just got to allocate some ports. So click on allocation again, type in the IP address. Oops. Let's get the IP address again. So like here, allocation, type the IP address in. Let's go, let's say we want 270.115, and then we want to open it all the way up to 27.025. So that's going to open up that range of ports, and then we click submit. And then here you go. So you can see it's opened up all these ports. So from here, if you ever want to start a server, you can just click on servers, create new, and then yeah, just fill out the details, such as a server name, server owner, and select what game you want to install. So that's it, guys.